There's a lot of attention about the most recent Trump rally where some people were yelling, go home to you, right. But then others were coming up asking for autographs.
Yeah.
Does that, in a nutshell, summarize this confused, twisted relationship?
I think it does to some extent. And, you know, listen, people are going to yell at us. They're going to tell us to go home. We're not going to go home. We're going to stay there. We're going to do our jobs. This elderly woman was whipping up the crowd into a frenzy and getting them to say, go home, Jim. But at the same time, you know, we talked to other people who said, hey, I don't agree with what you do. I don't agree with what you say, but I believe that you have a right to do it. You know, there was a man who came up to us at the rally and asked if anybody had a chair that we could lend so his elderly mother could sit down. I was happy to hand over my chair. And I was talking with the gentleman. It was interesting. You know, he said, I didn't realize that, you know, you were going to sing the national anthem when the national anthem played in the rally or say the Pledge of Allegiance. And I said, well, you know, I went to elementary school in this country. I'm an American. I know how to say the Pledge of Allegiance. So sometimes it's just about getting one-on-one with some of these folks, American to American. And I when you have that kind of one-on-one interaction, that kind of conversation, people tend to let, you know, some of those biases, some of those prejudices that they've developed from watching Fox News and so on to break away, and then you can have a real conversation.
Speaking of Fox, we took a look at what happens when you shout questions, either at the president or others. Let's take a look first at the video.
You say that you wanted more people
thank
to come
you
in
very
from
much.
Norway. Is that true, Mr.
Thank
President?
You very-
Mr. President, what about the DACA kids? Should they worry about what's going to happen to them, sir?
Mr. President, how's it going so far, sir? Mr. Kim, will you give up your nuclear weapons, sir?
When you yell questions, Jim, Fox News and others attack you. Yeah. We can show some of the examples for having an outburst, for asking harsh questions, for grandstanding. These are some of the headlines from FoxNews.com.
Right.
Why do you think there's so much resentment or criticism of the way you do this?
Well, to some extent, you know, the president, Fox News, they don't have Barack Obama around anymore. They don't have Hillary Clinton, although the president goes after Hillary Clinton a lot, so does Fox News. And so we've sort of replaced Obama and Hillary. They need somebody to attack, and I think that we've sort of filled that role. Part of the issue is I think, instead of wanting to focus on the president's behavior, they'd rather focus on our reporting on the president's behavior. For example, yesterday, you know, he tweeted out a bunch of false things that he had watched MS-13 liberate towns in this country. That never happened.
That ICE had liberated towns from MS-13?
Yeah, or ICE had liberated
towns
from MS-13, right? And then there was another one where he said, I didn't recommend that Republicans, go after and adopt new immigration legislation. That obviously, that is in direct contradiction with something that he tweeted earlier in the week. And so, you know, we spend a lot of our time spinning our wheels, calling out his falsehoods. That consumes a lot of the coverage, and it presents, I think, to the American people this sense that all we're doing all day long is bashing the president, when in fact we have to be fact checkers. And so we spend a lot of time simply just fact checking the president.
And fact checking sounds like bashing to a part of the population.
That's right. And I think, you know, listen, there are folks, and I, on the conservative side of the spectrum in the media, you know, I refer to them affectionately as the megaphone. They, by and large, just echo what the president wants to hear and what he wants to say. We see that a lot happening over on Fox News. I told people at that rally on Monday night in Columbia, listen, we're not going to just do the news for the Republicans. We have to do the news for everybody. And you may not like what you hear all the time. And the question I asked to a lot of people at that rally was, are you forming your conclusions on what we do based on watching CNN or watching other networks, our rivals and so on, and their coverage of what we do?
That's a great point.
And by and large, what I find is that people are developing their impressions of us by watching Hannity and so on. And I said, hey, you know, give us a chance, watch us, and then make up your mind.
Right, the pro-Trump media calls you fake news. They say you're a drama queen. I wrote down some of these slurs. Some of them I can't read because they're curse words.
Yeah.
Point is, though, when you're in the back of the room, like you were on Friday, and you shout a question to Trump, and he probably can't even hear it, isn't it true that you're kind of doing that just to get attention?
Well,
isn't that part of what you're doing?
On Friday, when I was shouting that question, I thought, first of all, he keeps calling us the enemy of the people. Somebody ought to ask him after what happened in Annapolis, are you going to continue to call us the enemy of the people? And so they had an event. They put him on all the other way, the other side of the room. But there was a moment towards the end of that event when he was walking towards us, and I thought, well, here's a chance to perhaps shout a question to him. And we have seen on occasion when we shout questions, he does answer the question. Mm-hmm. So it's not unreasonable to ask that question. It's not like we barge into the Oval Office or barge into the Easter egg roll and start shouting questions.
But there's a perception like, you do in order to get attention for yourself.
And what people don't understand is that typically at the very end of these pool opportunities, what we call pool opportunities, where we go in and talk to the president or he has an event, we wait until the very end of the bill signing or the event or whatever he has, and he says, okay, thanks, guys, and then we'll go in and we'll ask our questions. People don't understand there's a process to it, and you know we typically adhere to that process. Now, of course, they're not going to take our questions. We have to find opportunities to ask those questions, and that means
kind of like Sam Donaldson did decades ago.
That's right. And listen, if they want to send me to hell, I'll still be shouting at the devil, is the way I look at it. Mm-hmm. And you know, we have a job to do. I've said this before, and I'll say it again. They can kick us out of the briefing room. They can kick us out of the White House. We're still going to do our jobs. And, you know, my attitude is that we fill a necessary role in our democracy. The rest of the world is watching us. They don't understand how the president can call us fake news and the enemy of the people. And my response to all of that is, my goodness, are we supposed to sit back and do nothing? Are we supposed to not push back when we're treated in that fashion? And my sense of it is that you have to push back.
Real quick, I saw Sean Spicer's out pitching a TV show, a talk show. Has he tried to book you?
Yes, I did get a request for that. We politely turned that down. My sense of it is that Sean has sort of crossed the line from, you know, being somebody who is a former press secretary to somebody who wants to resurrect his career and go on Fox News and bash CNN. And if he's going to do that, I don't think we should give him time to do that. If he wants to have a civil exchange, I'm willing to do that. But my feeling up until this point is that he's just not willing to do that. And, you know, until that happens, I'm not really willing to go into that kind of situation. Mm.
And one of the big stories this week was about Bill Shine, the former Fox News co-president, now taking a big job at the White House. He's going to be in a big communications role. It's kind of controversial because Shine had to leave Fox in the wake of the Roger Ailes scandal. There were questions about how he handled some of the sexual harassment complaints. He's been named in a few lawsuits. Now, Shine's denied all wrongdoing, but this controversy continues. I wonder what it's going to mean to have a former Fox News co-president essentially running communications at the White House. Do we have any sense of what that's going to be like?
Well, we have so many people from Fox News who work at the White House, who have worked at the White House, that, you know, this is just a further, meshing of these two entities, the White House and Fox News. And, you know, what we have in this country right now, Brian, and people need to be aware of it, is we don't have what we have traditionally seen as the media's role in this country is having essentially a free press. We have what I would consider to be a system of state-supported media, in that you have a White House, you have a president. They lend so much support to one individual news network, which gives them beneficial coverage, that it has changed the nature of what we view as being our system of delivering the news in this country.
Wow.
You know, I think we have a system where one network benefits from a very symbiotic relationship from the White House, and we all have to grapple with that on a daily basis, as you know. Mm. I mean, on a daily basis, we think that the president is watching Fox and Friends, that he's going to tweet about Fox and Friends every morning, and we have to respond to that. We spend every day thinking, well, is he going to go on Fox News and talk to somebody, and we have to cover that. His top aides go on Fox News. You see this in the driveway of the White House. They'll go out,
right.
Kellyanne Conway and so on will go out, and then the press in the press room will respond, run out to the driveway and try to get those aides coming back in, because they won't talk to us individually. They'll go on Fox News because they know they're going to get a friendly platform. There was one day where Sarah Sanders, been a couple of days where Sarah Sanders didn't have a briefing. She was in town, could have easily had a briefing, instead went on Hannity and bashed us. This is a very symbiotic relationship. It's a very hard nut to crack. And I think Bill Shine going to the White House is just furthering that symbiotic relationship. And, you know, it's something that we're going to have to grapple with. I hope that he understands going in there that he's going to be working on behalf of the American people, not just one segment of the American people.
You have one of the most interesting jobs on television. Jim, thanks for being here.
Hey, thanks, Brian.
Great to see you.
Thanks so much.